The Phoenix Project was founded on October 24th, 1945. The second war to end all wars was over, but there were those who understood that we could no longer afford to think in terms of nations and empires. For a time, the Phoenix Project successfully navigated the political conflicts of its era. That was our golden age. Phoenix Project operatives scoured the world for clues. We had bases in 24 countries. Even the heavens were not off limits. But out there, on the far side of the moon, began our downfall. The failure of the Phoenix 2 mission exposed us to our enemies in the UN. Stripped of resources and scattered to the winds, we were reduced to a secret, a memory. When the Pandora virus woke up, we should have been the first line of defense. When huge clouds of mist appeared over the sea, when people started vanishing, we should have figured out what was going on. And when those people started coming back, changed, hostile, alien, we should have been ready to fight, but we failed. The ecosystem started to change, imperceptibly at first, then faster and faster. Three factions arose. New Jericho, trying to restore order and purity. Sanhedrin, hoping to build a world without hierarchies. And the Disciples of Anu, a new syncretic religion dedicated to adaptation and biological change. At war with the world and at odds with each other, these factions cannot find a way forward. Now the mist is returning and armies are rising from the sea. Without the Phoenix Project, humanity will fall. It's time to rise from the ashes. Thank you.
Moving out. Dashing ahead. Five by five. Let's roll. On the move. Here we go. Identifying target. Target down. Aiming. Enemy kill. I'm going. All set. Advancing.
I'm being honest about our flaws, because I think, crazily enough, the whole thing. You're welcome. I hope we can work together.
Research complete.
All set. Double time. Moving to coordinates. On the double.
Thank you.
stolen.
Ready to engage. Moving. Double time. On the move. Overwatching. Let's roll! Let's go.
Born again, anarchist.
Dashing ahead.
Taking aim. Oh. Research complete.
Sanhedrin was built on a dream. A world without hierarchies, without leaders, where human beings could embrace the potential of technology without its destructive side effects. The radicals of the old world had been proven right. The status quo could not sustain itself. But what now? What was the next step? Some argued for coexistence with the Pandoran ecosystem, hoping for a peaceful solution. Others advocated putting humanity before nature and claiming the planet for themselves. Trusting in the safety of their havens, the people of Sanhedrin argued about the best way forward, but the Pandora virus had little interest in their arguments, and its power was still growing.
Research complete.
I'm here. Enemy contact.
Right there. I'll keep my eyes open.
Right there. Advancing. I've got a visual. Moving to coordinates. Identifying target. Holding position. Aiming. Moving to coordinates. Thank you.
ready, sort of.
Ready to engage.
Identifying targets.
That should have gone better.
Holding position.
Taking aim.
Hold position.
Normally, when we encounter a potential ally, we first send the Apostle to the Onceborn to check them out. But I'm gonna break protocol to see. If you want to work with us, you'll still have to deal with them.
Research complete.
Randall Symes was the last leader of the Phoenix Project. His great-grandfather had been there when it was founded, and he was there to witness its end. When we took back Phoenix Point, we found his notes. In his final days, as the world collapsed around him, he had been working frantically to understand the Pandora virus. Somewhere in the complicated history of the project, in decades of missions and investigations, you Moving to position.
Identifying.
Bullseye.
Game.
On the double.
Let's go.
I'm here. Overwatching. Let's roll.
Moving now.
Right there. Position.
I'll keep my eyes open. Ready to fight.
Let's go.
Dashing ahead. On the move. They could be anywhere. Moving.
Sprinting to position.
I'm going.
Advancing. Moving.
Holding position.
Moving. Let's go.
Making haste.
On the move. On the move.
Holding position.
Moving out. Moving out.
I'll keep my eyes open.
Overwatching.
Let's go.
Making haste.
Moving. Let's go.
Repositioning, prioritizing speed.
Moving to coordinates. Advancing.
Running.
Right there. Moving.
Making haste.
I'm on the move.
I got this covered.
Holding position. Position.
I'm on Overwatch.
Overwatch. On the double.
I'm on the move.
Thank you.
As the world fell apart around us, it was difficult not to feel guilty. Some chose to be proactive and fight, but not me. I came here instead. My best weapon is my mind, and I need silence to put it to work. The history of the Phoenix Project is a complex tapestry. In Russia, Turkey, Britain, Spain, not one unbroken lineage, but a tangle of organizations, each passing the torch to the next with only one goal: to protect the human race. But protect it from what? Did they know about the Pandora virus? And if so, how? The answers are out there. So much has been investigated and collected and analyzed, but it's all scattered, lost. I don't know if it's possible to track it all down, but I have to try. There's only one thing I'm sure of. I can't stay here anymore.
Enemy contact. Overwatching.
Heading out.
Running.
Overwatching.
I see them.
Holding position.
Eat lead, sucker! Don't mess with me!
Moving. Ready to engage.
Moving out.
Set.
fire.
Ready to fire.
Action!
Identifying.
Moving.
Receiving loud and clear. Heading out.
Running.
Repositioning, prioritizing speed.
On the double.
Double time.
In the 1960s, the Phoenix Project clashed with an unknown intelligent outfit associated with the CIA. One of these clashes concerned the cultures stored in this lab, said to be responsible for a terrible plague somewhere in what was then called the Third World. At the time of his death, my great-grandfather was trying to force the CIA to at least share some samples, but they denied everything, even the existence of this lab. It looks like the research was abandoned in the late 1970s. I'm not sure why. The samples are degraded, but if my analysis is correct, this is the Pandora virus. Sometimes I wonder whether the only reason we survived as a species is sheer luck.
Thank you.